Jailbreaking a PS Vita is fun to do, but do you know how to undo or remove the jailbreak? Well, there is no official or written guide on how to do it, but I will try my best to show it to you. So, let's get started. Before doing anything, let's check the console condition by going into the settings. As you can see, we can see the Hankaku settings. It means that the console is already jailbroken. The next thing is to open the system information to find out its firmware version. For my case, the console is on firmware 3.65 and it is running Hankaku. If your console is running Hankaku without ENSO on 3.65 or 3.60, then you can simply reboot the console to remove the jailbreak. Now let's reboot the console and see if it is using ENSO. If you see the Molecule logo upon booting the console, then your console does have ENSO. ENSO is Auto Hankaku. It will stay permanently on your console until you remove it. Even formatting the console won't break it. The only way to remove it is to rerun the ENSO installer. But if you don't have the ENSO installer on your console, then you need to reinstall it using Vita Shell. In other hands, if you don't have Vita Shell, then you need to rehack the console. Watch my previous guide on how to do it. In this video, I assume that we already have Vita Shell, but we lost the ENSO installer, so let's reinstall it. Press the start button to open the Vita Shell main settings. Move the cursor down to select button option and choose either you want to use USB or FTP connection. In this video, I chose FTP. Press the select button and see the console's IP address. By the way, you need to connect your console to the same network as your computer to be able to use FTP connection. Download the latest version of WinSCP, then install it. Download the PS Vita Finalization Archive. See the link in the description below. Run WinSCP. Change the file protocol to FTP. Enter the console's IP address and port number. Then check anonymous login. Then press the login button. Navigate to the UX0 partition and enter the data folder. Double-click the Finalization Archive and navigate to the UX0 data folder. Depending on your console's firmware version, select the corresponding ENSO installer. For my case, I chose ENSO 3.65. Then select the update blocker. This file is optional, but it is okay to install it to your console. Drag both files to the UX0/data folder. Then we can close the WinSCP and the PS Vita Finalization Archive. Now press the cross button to close the FTP connection. Now enter the UX0 partition and enter the data folder. Mark all the VPK files with the square button. Then press the triangle button. Select more, then select install all. Then follow the on-screen instruction. Now we need to delete the installer files. Press the triangle button again, then press delete. Press the home button to get back into the home screen. The next step is optional, but run it if you don't know or don't remember if you ever used the Vita Update Blocker. Because if you ever use this app and miss this step, then you won't be able to update the console normally after removing the hack. Press the triangle button to unblock update downloads. Now press the circle button to unblock system update in settings. Now run the ENSO installer. By rerunning this app, we will be able to remove ENSO permanently. press the circle button to accept the terms. Then press the triangle button to remove ENSO. And press any key to reboot the console. After removing ENSO, you won't see the Molecule logo upon rebooting the console. The next step is to remove all the unofficial PS Vita app, or we can say all the homebrew apps. Open the Content Manager. Choose Manage Content on Memory Card. Select PS Vita. Check all the homebrew apps or non-legit games. Then press Delete. You can go back to the home screen, and now the console is back to its original state. Now you can update the console to the latest firmware. Open the settings. Select System Update. Select Update using Wi-Fi. Then follow the on-screen instruction. You can reopen the settings to find out the firmware version. It is now on the latest firmware, which is on 3.73 at the moment. The next step is optional, but if you want to resell your console, then you might need to reset the system. Follow the on-screen instruction. And there you go, you have successfully removed the PS Vita jailbreak and restored the console to factory settings. Thank you for watching, and see you guys later.